Hi guys, today I am going to give introduction how to prepare for any government electrical exam, either it is KPTCL or SCOM or KPCL or any electrical government exam, which are the concepts are very important that we are going to discuss now. First, you start with basic electrical. So first start with basic electrical. So purchase any book which has a name basic electrical. So once you purchase the basic electrical, you must start with the basic. So what is current? What is voltage? What is resistance? What is reactance? What is impedance? What is admittance? And what is Ohm's law? What is Faraday's law? And you have to be analyze all the topics in your own pattern. For example, here current. What do you mean by current? Current is a continuous flow of electrons in a conductor in particular direction. So next, another one definition is current is also rate of change of charge. Rate of change of charge. One charge is equal to 6.242 into 10 to the power of 18 electrons. So this much of basic and all you must have to be study, and you have to be remember all the formulas. Formulas are very important in competitive examples. Our rate of change of charge means I is equal to Q by T. And another one we having Ohm's law. In depth, in detail, I will explain in next video how to remember all the units. And according to the Ohm's law, I is equal to V by R. These are the two important formula for current. Then what is voltage, what is resistance, and what is Faraday's laws, what is Lenz's law, and what is inductor, what is capacitor. Inductor means it's just like a coil. It does not allow change in current. Resistance opposes the current. Inductor does not allow change in current. If it is 5 amps, if suddenly changes, inductor is not going to allow it. Means V is equal to L di by dt. So inductor is a storing device. It stores the energy in magnetic field. So next, capacitor. Capacitor means it stores the energy in electrical field. It opposes the change in voltage. Capacitive reactance will opposes the change in reactance. I is equal to C dv by dt. So this change in voltage does not allow. This change in current, it does not allow. So likewise, and for DC, inductor will be XL is equal to 2 pi FL. Frequency will be 0. For DC always frequency should be 0. Means XL is equal to 0. It acts as a short circuit. Here capacitance XC is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. Here frequency will be 0. Frequency will be 0 means it is a infinity. This is the way you have to be remember. Capacitance means it's a open circuit. So this much of basic concept, you have to be analyze all the topics in your own method, and you have to be revise more. Once more times you revise, you will be having more knowledge. So after this basic electrical, next go for electrical circuits. Then second important subject is electrical circuits. Electrical circuits or network analysis. Electrical circuit or network analysis. This is the also one of the important subject where they will ask more problems. So here they may ask resistance in series parallel, inductance in series parallel, then capacitance in series parallel, and what will be the, how to apply KVL, how to apply KCL and theorems. So, by using KVL and KCL, we can solve problems. Then why we need theorems? KVL and KCL, KVL is applied for loops. KCL is applied for node. So, if there are two loops, means it, there will be two equations. If there are five loops, means there will be five equations. In calculator, we can solve two or three equations, or manually you can solve two equations. But if more number of loops, means circuit will be complicated. So for complicated circuit, we will go for theorems. Which are the theorems are there? Superposition theorem, next Thevenin's theorem, next reciprocity theorem, Millman's theorem, maximum power transfer theorem, and another one theorem is also there. There are six theorems. Understand the each topic with the physical meaning, then it will be very easy. Then next unit will be resonance. Resonance is also a important topic. One or two questions they will ask in the resonance. What is series resonance? What is parallel resonance? Actually, what is the meaning of resonance? I will show how to remember one formula in resonance. Here XL is equal to XC, means if it is the R, it will be X and it will be XC. XC and XL will get cancelled. Only resonance means only resistance will exist. So XL is equal to XC means XL is equal to 2 pi FL. XC is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. So if frequency comes this free, F square is equal to 1 by 2 pi into 2 pi. We can touch 2 pi square, L into C. Square root on both sides. It will be F is equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC. This is the resonant frequency. So F, resonant frequency F is equal to 1 by 2 pi root LC. If you remember like this wise, means you can no need to buy out the formulas. If you know the basic and if you derive like this, means it's very easy to remember lifelong. So next, after electrical circuit, go for machines. So in machines, how you are going to start, means first start with DC generator. So what is the working principle of DC generator? Whenever the flux cut by a conductor, an EMF will be induced. What is the output equation of DC generator? Pi ZNP by 60A. Then what is A? A means parallel path. For lap, A is equal to P, means here number of parallel path is equal to number of pole. For wave, always parallel path is equal to 2. And what is lap? What is wave? Why lap is used for low voltage and high current? Why wave is used for high voltage and low current? Likewise, you have to be here, it will be low current and high voltage. Low current and high voltage, lap will be low voltage and high current. Why? Likewise, these are the things are there. What is the difference between them? You have to be study each topic. What is shunt generator? What is series generator? What is compound generator? What will be the output characteristics of different generator? What is OCC curve? What is residual flux? Likewise, you have to be completely study DC generator. Once you completed DC generator, then go for DC motor. Whenever the generator comes, means EMF equation is very important. Whenever the DC motor comes, means torque equation will be important. What is the torque equation? Pi Z IAP by 2 pi into A. This is the torque equation of DC motor. For the series motor, torque is proportional to IA square. For series motor, for shunt motor, torque is proportional to IA. Where we use DC series motor? Where we need high starting torque. For example, in locomotive, you are going to use DC series motor. Where we need constant speed, then we go for DC shunt motor. Here another one important topic is DC motor never start at no load, because at no load current will be more it will go for enormous speed. So DC motor never start at no load condition. So once you learn the DC motor, then go for transformer. Transformer output will be electrical only. So here E is equal to 4.44 F pi into N. If you want primary side E1 and N1, secondary side E2 N2. So and another one, another two important terms are Turns ratio, transformation ratio. Transformation ratio is nothing but K, N2 by N1, V2 by V1, I1 by I2. Reverse of transfer function is turns ratio, N1 by N2, V1 by V2, I2 by I1 or 1 by K. So these are the two definitions. Likewise, we have different terms in why transformer rated in KVA and what happens if transformer is connected to a DC, what is core type transformer, what is shell type transformer, what is the condition for step up voltage, what is the conditions for step down voltage, what is the parallel operation of transformer condition, when transformer maximum efficiency will be there, what are the formulas, and what is eddy current loss, what is hysteresis loss. In depth you have to be studying transformer. Once you completed transformer, then go for induction motor. Induction motor is a very important topic. Here they will ask in every exam one or two question on induction motor. What is the torque equation of three phase induction motor? 3 pi by 2 pi ns, E2 S times E2 R2 by R2 square plus X time X2 square. So this is the torque equation of induction motor. When torque will be maximum, R2 is equal to S times X2. Torque will be maximum. Maximum torque will not depend on the resistance. And what will be the, why single phase induction motor is not self starting, why three phase induction motor is a self starting, and what is the condition for maximum torque, and what are the different types of induction motor, what is split phase induction motor, what is capacitor start induction motor. You have to be studying in depth this induction motor. Once you completed the induction motor, then go for alternator or synchronous generator. So next go for alternator or synchronous generator. Alternator or synchronous generator. Mainly here construction, rotor will be two types, silent pole, non-silent pole. Silent pole and non-silent pole. Silent pole means pole will be projected. It will be used for low speed like hydro. Non-silent means it will be cylindrical. It will be rotating at high speed. It will be used for thermal or nuclear power plants. So in depth you have to be study what actually the difference between them. Why it is actually low speed? Why it is actually high speed? If it is rotated at the high speed, what will happen? And what is the EMF equation of alternator or synchronous generator? What is the condition for parallel operation of alternator? In depth you have to be study this topic. Once you completed this, then go for synchronous motor. Synchronous motor means here NS will be constant. NS is equal to 120 F by P. Synchronous motor means it should be always at synchronous speed. Remember, synchronous motor never self-starting motor. They will use pony motor, means normal induction motor to start the synchronous motor. There are different methods to start the synchronous motor, damper winding, and in DC generator, what is dummy coil here, what is damper winding, what is the function of damper winding in synchronous motor, what is the function of damper winding in synchronous generator. In that, you have to be study these things. Next, last topic in motors, special motors. In special motors, hysteresis motor is an iceless motor which is used in tape recorder, and it is a rotated synchronous speed. And reluctance motor is also there, it will also run at synchronous speed. You have to be study this much of concepts in machines. Once you completed machines, then go for another very important subject, measurement. Another very important subject, measurements. In measurements, we have different types of bridge. For resistance, we have three types of resistance: low resistance, medium resistance, high resistance. Which is the effective method for low resistance? Kelvin double bridge. Which is the best bridge for medium resistance? It will be Wheatstone bridge. For high resistance, we use Megger. So these are the important bridges to measure the resistance. This is DC bridge. If you come to the AC bridge, for inductance, remember the one shortcut, means ohm. Remember the ohm. H means AC bridge, O means OS bridge, M means Maxwell inductance bridge, A means Anderson bridge, M means Maxwell inductance capacitance bridge. For quality factor greater than 10, we will go for AC bridge. For quality factor greater than 10, we will go for AC bridge. Quality factor less than 10, we will go for Maxwell inductance capacitance. OS bridge is as a 2 capacitor bridge. Anderson is a 5 point bridge. So next, Maxwell inductance bridge, we can't measure the quality factor. So likewise, what is the difference between comparison is very important in competitive exams. Compare in each bridge, what is the difference between them, and if possible, derive the equations for all the bridges. So next, for capacitance. Capacitance, remember SC, SD. SD means Shekhar Dhawan is a famous cricket player. So remember, capacitance means Shekhar Dhawan. Here, what is the full form of S? S means sharing bridge. D means Desartis bridge. This way, made the shortcut so you can remember in lifelong. For inductance, ohm. For capacitance, it will be Shekhar Dhawan. So, next, for any instrument, we need different types of torque. To move the pointer, we need deflecting torque. If you want to, meter is likewise, if you want to move this, we need some force, thus, or some torque, that is deflecting torque. If you move this pointer, it will reach at end. If you force only from this side, means it will reach at end. We need opposition force also, that is controlling torque. When two forces are providing me, it will oscillate. To reduce the oscillate, we need damping torque. So these are the three important types of torques. Deflecting torque is produced by either magnetic effect or electrostatic effect, different types of effect, we will get deflecting torque. Controlling torque has yet two functions. One, it has to be opposite the deflecting torque, and when the power supply is off, it has to be bring back to the zero position. And how the spring is made up of, what are the conditions, you have to note down all the points. Then two different types of controlling torque are there, spring control and gravity control. Then damping torque. Damping torque means to reduce the oscillation. We have three types of damping: fluid friction damping, eddy current damping, air friction damping, fluid friction damping, eddy current damping. If you want effective means, eddy current is the most effective damping. Likewise, you have to be remember all the formulas, then you will be more confident. So what is PMMC instrument, why PMMC instrument is used for only DC, and why induction is used for only AC. Only PMMC instrument will be having linear scale, like that our points are very important in measurement. So once you completed measurements, once you completed measurements, then go for electrical power generation, EPG. In EPG, you have to be study all the different types of power plant: hydro, thermal, nuclear. In hydro, what is surge tank, why they provided surge tank, what is penstock, what is tiled race, and which are the types of turbines are there for I-8, Pelton is used, why they use for I-8, Pelton, and what is Kaplan turbine, what is reaction turbine, what is impulse turbine. You have to be study these topics in hydro. Then for thermal, you have to be study different materials. So what is super heater, what is economizer, what is the how coal is coming to the furnace, and how the process will go on.